Hi, my name is Gabe. I'm a mathematician and a tutor, and I'm excited to dive into some statistics with you. Today, we will discuss how to handle combinations of multiple random variables. First, we will define a linear combination of random variables. We will then discuss the relationship between the mean, variance, and standard deviation of individual random variables and these values for combinations of random variables. As we are discussing these points, we will also specify the conditions for combining random variables using these rules. Let's begin by thinking about when being able to combine random variables may be useful. Let's say that on the way to school, you have to bike from home to the train station, then take a train from the station to school. Sometimes you bike fast, sometimes you bike slow. Similarly, sometimes there is a delay on the train, sometimes there is not. You want to know how early you need to leave home to be very sure that you won't be late to school, but you've only kept track of how long it takes you to bike to the train station, because once you're at the train, it's out of your control. Well, the time that you spend on your bike can be your first random variable, x, while the time on the train, which maybe your friend has reported, would be some random variable, y. You would be interested in having a value for the variable x plus y to find your total travel time. Let's take a look at how we combine these random variables in general, then we will come back and take a look at this problem. We are going to restrict ourselves to linear combinations of random variables. A linear combination of two or more variables consists of multiplying each variable by some constant and then combining those terms by addition. Since these constants can be positive or negative, it is possible to have addition or subtraction of variables in a linear combination. Let's put this idea into mathematical language. Given two random variables x and y, we can construct a linear combination L. Throughout this video, it is assumed that these random variables are independent of one another. All the formulas to follow hold only if this is true. The linear combination L is equal to A times X plus B times Y. Here, A and B are constants which can be either positive or negative. The linear combination of these variables L is also a random variable. The two most basic cases are the sum, where we simply have A and B equal to 1, or the difference where A is equal to 1 and B is equal to negative 1. It is possible to have more than two terms in a linear combination, but the consequences are the same, and we just need to keep track of more letters. At this point, it is important to consider what information we either gain or lose when combining random variables like this. Specifically, how are the properties of the combined variable, such as the mean, variance, and standard deviation, connected to those properties in the original variables? Luckily, there are clear relationships between these terms, which we can outline now. Given two random variables x and y, and constants a and b, and the means for those respective random variables as mu x and mu y, we can again define a linear combination L as ax plus by. To determine the mean value of the random variable L, which we denote as mu L, we simply take the linear combination of the means of x and y, which we write as a times mu x plus b times mu y. Let's take a look at this with our commute example. Recall that the random variable for your time on a bike is x, while the random variable for your time on the train is y. Let's also rewrite your overall commuting time random variable x plus y as t to represent total time. Let's say that mu x is equal to 10 minutes, while mu y is equal to 25 minutes. What then is the value of mu t? What is the linear combination that we are working with? Try to write out the answer using the form of a linear combination. Welcome back. Hopefully you were able to make use of the linear combination formulas to solve this problem. We have constructed the random variable t from ax plus by, and thus the mean of t is going to be equal to a times mu x plus b times mu y. Since we have the simple case of a equals 1 and b equals 1, that means that we can just get mu t from mu x plus mu y, or 10 plus 25 equals 35. But what about the variance and the standard deviation? How does this uncertainty propagate through linear combinations? Given two random variables x and y and constants a and b, and the variances for the respective random variables as sigma squared x and sigma squared y, we can again define a linear combination L as ax plus by. To determine the variance of the random variable L, which we denote as sigma squared L, we have to account for the more complicated nature of variance calculations. This leads to the formula that the variance of L is equal to a squared times the variance of x plus b squared times the variance of y. Just remember that this equation only holds when the random variables x and y are independent of one another. It is important to note that because we are squaring the constants here, there is no way for the variance of the combined variable to be smaller than the variance of either individual variable. This makes sense, as two random events should lead to more randomness, not less. Finally, we need to consider how to get the standard deviation of a linear combination. To do so, we have to recall that the standard deviation of a random variable is equal to the square root of its variance. This means that we just need to follow the derivation for the variance to the final step, then take the square root. That is, that sigma L will be equal to the square root of the quantity A squared times the variance of X plus B squared times the variance of Y. Let's see how this applies to the train problem. We can keep mu X as equal to 10 minutes and mu Y to 25, but add on that we have the variance of sigma squared X equal to 3 minutes, and of sigma squared Y is equal to 8 minutes. Let's say now, however, that we are exploring the difference in travel time on the two legs per day, for which we will need some new random variable D, which is equal to X minus Y. From here, we want to know about the variance in the time that we spend on biking versus taking the train. That is, we need to know sigma squared D. Let's make sure that we make full use of the linear combination formula to solve this problem. We have constructed the random variable D from AX plus BY, this time with A equal to 1 and B equal to negative 1. The variance of D is equal to A squared times the variance of X plus B squared times the variance of Y. Plugging in our values, we have that the variance of D is equal to 1 squared times 3 plus negative 1 squared times 8. Together, these two sum to 11. Notice how the variance of the difference is greater than the variance of either individual term. This is because the negative sign associated with subtraction is squared away in this formula, leading to the addition of the variances. Before we close, it is crucial to note some of the limitations of this process. Most importantly, these linear combination rules only apply to random variables of the same type. For example, we can combine two normally distributed variables, but not a normally distributed random variable and a binomial random variable. Similarly, we can combine binomial random variables with the same underlying probability of success, but we cannot directly combine random variables with mismatched probabilities. In this lesson, we have covered the basic concept of a linear combination. We then applied linear combinations to random variables and discussed the effects of this on the mean, variance, and standard deviation of the combined random variable. We particularly noted how the variance of a combined variable is always additive, even if the combined variable is based on a difference. Finally, we discussed when it is possible to combine random variables and when this framework does not apply. Overall, this video has been a brief introduction to combinations of random variables. For more practice on this topic, I encourage you to keep learning with other resources available at Chegg.